not take, he may not lose time. Thank you, Father God. Amen. Leemos así, we'll be reading in the name of our Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
To everything,
there is a season.
Amen.
Gloria a Dios.
To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven.
Lo leemos en español. Todos juntos, unánimes.
Amen. Amen. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. Se puede sentar, hermanos.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Gloria a Dios.
Gloria a Dios. The book of Ecclesiastes is lumped together as a book of poetry. However, there is no rhyme in the book of Ecclesiastes. There's only reason. See, in the order that you have the books of poetry or the books of wisdom in the Old Testament, you have Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and the Songs of Solomon. Right? Amen? Amen. Otherwise, they could be named in this order, and they have this motif. The Psalms are songs to God. The book of Proverbs are words from God. The book of Ecclesiastes are the thoughts of God. And the book of Song of Solomon, it's about sex and God. Everybody got uncomfortable when I said that. But who better else to speak to us about the nature of Adam and Eve than the Creator himself?
Amen.
I'm noticing that within our culture as Hispanics, los padres a veces no hablan a sus hijos detrás de estas cosas. It just doesn't happen overnight. Glory be to God. This reasonable book, the book of Ecclesiastes, it's a book that tries to find a balance between the vanities of life and God. The vanities, there's so many vanities. The author, King Solomon himself, vanity of vanities, all is vanity, right? He would go on to say, why should a man work if all he's going to do is die? And so, why should you work so that someone else in the future will have all of your possessions? Vanity of vanity, all is vanities, right? Yo puedo decir, hay gente que trabaja muy duro y después, el segundo generación se goza de todo de lo que hemos trabajado. So why work so hard? Vanity, vanity. One of the vanities that King Solomon mentioned and spoke of was considering time. And as we read, he says, in Ecclesiastes, to everything there is a season. When I was a kid, my father would turn on Cool 105.9, the old rock station, and there was a song, the group called The Birds. And they actually sang that song, to everything there is a season. And I learned that verse because of that song. And yeah, glory be to God. And I started questioning, what is a season? And we always do that. Nosotros como humanos siempre preguntamos a Dios, ¿hasta cuándo? ¿Hasta cuándo? We always ask God, how long? How long? How long do I have to be in this? How long do I have to be persecuted? How long do I have to suffer? How long do I have to put up with this?
Amen.
This message, God showed me, God had to shut me up like Job. And I think he has to do it for everybody. Why? Because we have three steps. And here's the first step. You're asking God, how long? How long? How long? How long? Guess what? It's not your place to know how long.
Amen.
That's right.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
No es su parte, no es su suerte, no es su puesto para tú preguntar a Dios how long.
Right.
You didn't earn those stripes that Jesus earned on the cross of Calvary.
Amen.
You're barely suffering a bruise.
Yes.
We are barely suffering bruise. We ain't do nothing. Jesus did everything. But we do it. We always ask God, how long? You will never know the time. Only God knows. The book of Acts chapter 1 verse 7, everyone. The Book of Acts, the Actions of the Apostles. Acts 1, verse 7. And it reads as such. And let's give some context real quick. When they therefore, the apostles that were gathered with Jesus before he ascended into heaven, when they therefore were come together and asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? He said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. It's not for you to know. Shouldn't it be enough to know that you are loved? Shouldn't it be enough for you to know that you have been saved? Isn't it? Shouldn't it be enough to know that the God that you serve can part the Red Seas, make the impossible possible, who can take what is not and make it what is? Isn't it enough for you?
Amen.
Hay cristianos aquí que no, que no, que no. It's not enough. You want more from God. You want so much more. It's not for you. Jesus doesn't play any games. Everybody likes to think about Jesus. So Jesus is a God of love. Jesus is the Son. He's the Lamb. Jesus won't hurt nobody. Jesus will hurt you. Because the Word of God says that whomever falls upon this rock shall be broken. But whoever will have this rock fall upon them shall be destroyed. How many people want to be broken? And how many want to be destroyed? You see, it's one thing to question the Almighty God. You're running the risk of being destroyed. Another thing is entirely being shattered upon the rock of Jesus Christ. Everything you know, everything you think you know is true. Everything you think you know is right. 1 + 1 is not equal 2 when we're talking about God. God can do whatever it is that he wants, and you should be happy, and you should rejoice, and you should be blessed when you actually think that everything happens for a reason and that he loves you.
Yeah.
That should be enough.
Amen.
But you got Christians who's not enough. Like the blood of the Lamb didn't wash over all of their sins. Look, hermanos, when I came to the realization in my 20s that Jesus Christ, what he did on the cross of Calvary, cleansed all of my sins. Say with me, all. Say all. Does that not feel good? I'm going to tell you why it feels good. Because the things that you don't know that you're going to do, all. Because the things that you're doing right now and that you know that you're doing and that you want to do, all. Because it's not just the sins of the past that have been forgiven. Hay muchos cristianos que piensan que lo que hizo Jesucristo en el cruz de Calvario solo era por la borrachera que tenía en el tiempo de antes. It's just because all the adulterous sex that I've been having while I didn't know Jesus. No! All sins have been forgiven by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
That should be enough.
Glory to God.
It is not for you to know the times and the seasons. Because that should be enough. What I love about Jesus here, let's just take a look at verse 8. A lot of brothers and sisters, they use verse 8 and they use it in a strange context. Let's look at it. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and into Judea and Samaria and to the utmost parts of the earth. Question, what sense does verse 7 make with verse 8? Have you ever looked at it? Look at it together. Jesus says it's not for you to know the times. And then when I love English, I love English. And in English, you never start a sentence with a conjunction. You never, but Jesus says, but. Jesus redirects the focus. It's what I love about Jesus. In verse 8, Christ will always redirect you into the mindset that you have to work. You got the apostles sitting here worrying about, what are you going to do about the kingdom? What are you going to restore the kingdom? En estos tiempos, we figured out, Israel quiere significar pueblo de Dios. The people of God, the children of God. So the children of God are always asking, when are you going to restore the kingdom? When are you going to restore the kingdom? I serve Jesus Christ. Shouldn't my life be flowers? Shouldn't I have a better job? Shouldn't everything that I do in my life be favored by God? Shouldn't I be blessed, not stressed? Shouldn't I be happy all the time? It's not for you to know the times, Christian. It's okay to know that you have been blessed by God. Yes. But there are some brothers and sisters that we will be reading about very soon that while they were blessed, they were persecuted. Mm-hmm. While they were blessed, they were put under stress.
Yes.
While they were blessed, they were watching family members being dragged out of their homes because they were saying, I believe in God. Not too long ago in the 90s, there was a young lady who, looking at the barrel of a gun in Columbine, said, I believe in Jesus. And she got shot in the face. So pardon me, if I gotta stop you right where you are. Glory be to God. Jesus Christ has a way of changing your perspective on things.
Yes.
Jesús te cambia. Because we all go our own way. The Bible says you strike the shepherd and the sheep will flee. Mm-hmm. We got to admit that that's what happens to us. If something goes wrong, we go crazy. And it has to be Jesus that puts the blinders on your head so that you can see what you're supposed to be seeing.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Jesus always uses words and he always uses actions. Washing the disciples' feet. Do this. You guys see? I want you to do this. Redirecting them because they didn't know. Lord, if you're going to wash my feet, wash everything. No, Peter. No, that doesn't make sense. Wash the feet, because I'm washing the feet. Serve your brothers the way I, your Lord and Savior God, am serving you.
Amen.
Redirect, because we ask stupid questions. We do. Oh, no one likes to know that, but we do. The Bible says, you ask, but you ask amiss so that you can spoil what you have been given. That was Paul. Mm-hmm. A veces nosotros pedimos cosas para satisfacer nuestros deseos carnales. We ask God for a car, not so we can drive and go to church. No, it's because we want to go to the drag strip with it. No. You don't get to set the parameters because you are temporal and the God that we serve is eternal. You are terrestrial and God is in space. Everybody, glory be to God.
Praise the Lord, amen. Glory to me. Hallelujah.
We see it with his words. Peter, do you love me? Peter, do you love me? Peter was defeated. Peter was destroyed. Mm-hmm. The devil prior had, Jesus had to tell Peter straight up and flat out, Satan asked me for you. Satan wanted me to give you up. But what happens here? Three crows? Roosters, never mind, not crow. Three rooster crows, and then what happens? Everything Peter knows has been destroyed. If it's not, si no está fundado en la roca, va a caer. Peter thought he was so big and bad. He thought he knew the seasons. He thought he knew the times. He thought he had a grasp on life. No, you don't, Peter. You don't understand what's going on. Mira, hermanos, nosotros tenemos que someternos.
Amen.
Porque Dios lo sabe todo.
Amen.
Y no como la gente que está en la calle, Porque la gente que está en la calle te puede decir, yo sé más que usted. Your bosses will let you know straight out, I know more than you. But Jesus doesn't do that. Jesus doesn't lord it over you. You see, Jesus wasn't the Lion of Judah. He's the Lamb. Jesus isn't sitting here roaring all this stuff. No, Jesus, por la vía dolorosa. I don't need to scream. Los romanos querían que Jesucristo gritara. Jesus didn't scream. Why? Porque hay poder en la resistencia. We need to learn just like Jesus. When you are able to resist, you are being strengthened then by the power of God. The power of God isn't about this gaudy display of glory and power. No, it's about resistance.
Amen.
God will show his power, but you don't want to be there when he does.
Praise the Lord.
Glory be to God. Amado jóvenes, have faith in God.
Amen.
Amado jóvenes, you will never know the time. God knows the time. You guys are, what, 17? I don't remember what I was doing at 17. I was 30. I'm 30. Ay, santo. Apenas me cortaron el pelo hoy, yo miré así. Yeah, ay, no, se me está yendo todo. See, I didn't know about time management. Los jóvenes... Tú sabes que los jóvenes tienen que graduar para estar al mismo nivel de los jóvenes y de lo que está pidiendo la sociedad. Los jóvenes tienen que tener su asociado mientras que están en high school.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say that in English. Did you know that society is so advancing now that if you don't graduate high school with an associate's degree, you are left behind? Don't read the book, because I'm telling you right now.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Los jóvenes tienen, with all these social advancements,